Chris Chinnock here for Insight Media. It's EVA 2023. We are in the Samsung booth looking at their microLED TVs. Of course, Samsung showed these at CES, so they're showing a new versions here this year at EVA. Specifically, what they're showing at the far end there is a 76-inch going to an 89-inch, 101-inch, and then this one straight in front of us here is 114-inch. Now, each of these are made with a module that's about 12 inches in diagonal. It's a glass module. So it's low temperature poly on glass. For the module, the size of the LEDs, they don't say specifically what it is, but it's less than 50 microns specifically. And they're rectangular, so you can do RGB. These are using in the manufacturing process. These are discrete RGBs with gallium nitride green and blue, and in Allen gap red, the traditional red LED. So each of these TVs are made with modules, as I said. So the 89 inches, which one we're looking at right here. Is made with a 7x7 array of modules. The smaller one, the 76 inch, is 6x6. The next size, the 101, is an 8x8 array, and the 114 inch is a 9x9 array. So let's talk a little bit about the what they're revealing in the innovation room also for the microLED manufacturing. They're actually revealing quite a lot. So let's take a look. So Samsung revealed a lot of new information about their microLED manufacturing process in their innovation room. We weren't allowed to take any photos in there or videos. So let me try and summarize what I saw in there. First of all, let's start at the wafer level. So one of the things they pointed out is as you go smaller and smaller in LED size, the efficiency drops. This is well known because the edges contribute more to defects, and the efficiency drops, especially below 10 microns. Now, their microLEDs are not that small, but they claim they've solved some of the efficiency droop problems with size. Again, I don't know exactly what those size are, but and they're using conventional discrete LEDs at this point. So that's one good innovation. In the backplane, they are using glass, as I said before, with LTPS, but they've designed special circuits for each microLED. In a TFT, of course, is only a single transistor to drive the LCD, but in microLEDs, it's a current source as opposed to a voltage source. They've developed a 19 transistor drive circuit for each LED. So those are very small. I don't know what design rule they're using, but they look pretty comparable in size, according to the graphic anyway, to the microLED. Now, that actually leaves a lot of space because they're using a 0.5 millimeter pitch on their modules. So, in fact, they've got about a 99% black area on each of these modules. So that's really, really impressive. And they actually had a little glass vial that had maybe a quarter inch of what looked like sand in it. And I was told this is actually 24 million microLEDs. That's your 4K TV in a tiny little vial. You just spread them out over an 89 or a 100-inch panel, and then you got a beautiful TV. The backplane is one innovation. The second innovation on the backplane is connectivity. So you have to have a bezel-less module if you're going to put these together into a display, because they're constructed, obviously, with multiple modules. So they've created a contacts that run over the edge and underneath the glass panel, because you can't do vias through the glass. I mean, you can, but not at this pitch. So they had to design contacts that went around the edge. So that's an important innovation, I thought, because there's other electronics that are on the backside. And as far as the row and the column drivers, they actually embed those on the front of the backplane as well, along where the microLEDs are placed. And when we get to mass transfer, they're using a laser transfer process. They've disclosed that some time ago, and they claim this is now about 300 times as fast and accurate as a single pick and place. That's not telling you too much information about the process, but apparently it's good enough for mass production at this point. They also have an algorithm that they use during this mass transfer process that helps to homogenize the uniformity of the module. So remember, each of these microLEDs has a variation of binning in the luminance and the wavelength. And if you just picked them and placed them as they came off the wafer, you would have non-uniformities. So they measure each of these devices and then use an algorithm to kind of randomize them the placement, so they do get a nice uniform module in red, green, and blue that way. Now, when they start to assemble these modules into a display, they have a nice clean edges here for the contacts, which is great, but the part of the issue now is edge detection. Not only do these glass modules have to be planar, but you can get light leakage, light from the outside, light from the LEDs themselves. So they've actually added AR coating on the edges of these modules and on the backsides, so to minimize kind of where you would see the seams normally. So that's part of the process of automating the placement during the display manufacturing process when they're building their 7x7 arrays or whatever for the 89-inch. Now, the 89-inch is the first one that's now in mass production, and it is a beautiful TV, I have to tell you. It has the styling of a Neo QLED, so it's got the thin profile with the speakers on the edges and backfiring speakers as well. The sound is actually quite good coming out of it. The planarity is amazing. It's deep black, and you cannot see where these tiles come together. That's kind of the... it's an amazing feat of engineering, I have to admit. So I think that's pretty much it for what they revealed so far on the microLED manufacturing. I'm calling this their 89-inch now kind of the new gold standard for how I judge other microLED implementations. So that's the good news for Samsung. That's Chris Chenock here for Insight Media.